I just got the new iPhone 14 Pro Max, and today I'm going to do a video unboxing this iPhone and going over new features of this phone. I'm trying to make it as simple as possible for even people who don't know a lot about tech to understand and decide if this phone is for you. Okay, without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, so I got the iPhone 14 Pro Max Deep Purple 256GB. It is one of the two new colorways this year, the Deep Purple and the Space Black. It's been such a long time since I unboxed a new iPhone. The phone that I'm using currently is the iPhone 10, which was 5 years ago. The feeling of unboxing the new phone is really new to me. We got the iPhone itself. It is the iPhone 14 Pro Max Deep Purple, and also in the box we have some manuals and some documents here, stickers that they gave us here, the USB-C to lightning cable. Recently Apple didn't provide the power adapter, so we have to buy it separately, which I got at Apple as well. I'm going to talk about the iPhone. It's not too thick, and the color, when you hear deep purple, you would think that it would be at least purple, like vibrant purple, but it looks more like a very dark purple, almost black. You can only see the purple color when you look at specific lighting, and it would pop up the color, which is a tint of purple. We have the three cameras here, the main 48 megapixel camera, ultra wide lens camera, which is 12 megapixels, and we also got the telephoto camera, which is also 12 megapixels. One thing, you have to be super careful if you want to use it for international purpose, like you want to travel to different countries, or you want to buy it for your relatives, your family in another country like Vietnam, because the US edition, they don't have the SIM tray. So Apple want to move to the eSIM, which is using the SIM electronically. A lot of countries, they do not support the eSIM, so it would cost a little bit of trouble if you want to buy it and then use it for international purpose. Okay, pretty much it looks like the same, like basically the same as iPhone 13 Pro Max. Not really different, but the real difference is going to be inside here, the screen. iPhone 14 Pro Max clear case, MagSafe. So this is the case that I'm going to use for this one. Here I got the USB-C power adapter. And the last thing I bought is the screen protector. So I got this one on Amazon. Okay, now I'm going to put on all of the accessories onto the phone and we're moving to talk about the features of this new phone. Okay, now we're moving on to talk about the new features of this new phone. So the first thing is the A16 Bionic processor. If you get the iPhone 14 or iPhone 14 Plus, you're going to get the same chip as last year Pro lineup, which is the A15 Bionic processor. Still a very powerful chip. But for the iPhone 14 or iPhone 14 Pro Max, you're going to get the new A16 Bionic processor, which is the solid powerhouse and the most advanced chip ever in the smartphone market. Usually for a typical user, you would not really care about all of the things that happen inside the phone or all of those numbers, but to break it out a little bit simple, it's gonna make your phone a lot more powerful. So if you try to run a game that is very intensive in the graphic, you're gonna have a very smooth experience. Or if you want to work with those editing tools, it's gonna help you a lot. Later on in this video, I'm going to talk about more of the features, and all of those new features are enabled by this new chip, like the dynamicisland, the always-on-display, or the battery life and the camera. All of those are happening because of this new chip. Okay, I'm going to talk about the display, which is the feature that a lot of people anticipate in this Pro lineup. It is something they call dynamicisland, which is the notch, the new notch they introduced this year. Apple decided to get rid of the bunny ears and replace it with a seamless transition between hardware and software. So it could show you a lot of notifications, alerts, or now a lot of apps are incorporating this feature into their apps. Also, something in the display section is the always-on display. So instead of just tapping on your phone every time you want to look at the time or on the notifications, now you can just glance at your phone. So it's pretty convenient. Okay, so the next two features are something that I don't think I would use a lot or ever use them. The first thing is the SOS emergency via satellite. It's a feature that lets you communicate with the emergency center if you don't have cellular or Wi-Fi. I think in the concept, you would really like hold your phone up to the satellite. They would show you the direction, and then you can have the options to send them text messages or those preset texts. The next feature is the crash detection, which is the feature that I hope none of us gonna use it. Basically, if you ever got into a car accident that cut a big, they're gonna detect it and then send you a message. If you don't respond to the message in time, they would automatically send it to the hotline support center, like the 911 in the US. But what I really concern is that if you live in a country that really don't have those kind of support, would you be able to use it? But it's pretty nice that Apple think about the safety of people and have this new feature. Now I'm going to talk about the biggest upgrade that they make this year. Also the reason that I decided to upgrade to this new phone, which is the camera. The wonderful 48 megapixel camera with a quad pixel sensor, the more megapixels you have, the sharper the image gonna look. So if you want to zoom in your photos without exposing the pixel structure of your photos, you would be able to do that on this new iPhone. This camera gonna allow you to have very good night mode photos. The cinematic mode is available in 24 frames per second and 30 frames per second, and they allow true up depth after capture. And one thing that I really like about this phone is the stabilization. It would not be able to get rid of the use of gimbal, but you would be able to take very good action videos. Okay, and some additional features that I'm going to go very briefly is the battery. So the battery is upgraded to 29 hours of video playback for the new iPhone Pro Max. This is going to be slightly better than last year's Pro lineup, but I don't think that you would see a lot of difference here, especially with the always-on display. And the last thing is the 2x brighter display. If you are like me, I would really hate it when I'm driving in the sun and then the display is kind of blown out, so I could not see it. But this time, it's gonna be a lot better under the sun, so it's pretty good. Okay, so now is my take. Is it worth it to upgrade to this new iPhone? I would say that if you are in the generation of iPhone 12 or iPhone 13, you would not really see a hardware innovation in this new iPhone. But if you are an Apple fan, an Apple stan, and you have extra money to spend on, just go for it because of the dynamic island, the always-on display, or the cameras. So the camera is a beast, I would say. I would go for it because of the camera. Okay, so that's it for this quick review on this new iPhone. If you like this video, please leave a like, a comment, and share this video. Subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram. So I'll see you guys in the next videos. Bye!